Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on, give a high five to your neighbor. Tell them, neighbor, you are welcome in the presence of God. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Just give high five, give high five, give high five. Hallelujah. Take your seats. Just imagine if you were a food. What kind of a food? Hallelujah. Amen. I want to welcome everybody who's watching us on Facebook. God is right there. I wanted to share our page. Connect yourself to the power. God will bless you. Put your two hands for Jesus. Wonderful people. God bless you. The reason why some of us we don't get sick is because every day we minister to the Lord. Minister to the Lord every day. Every day we minister to the Lord. We minister to How must I receive? How must I receive? Number one, your faith. How must I receive? Number one, your faith. If you can believe, you shall speak to this mountain. The Bible says, if you can believe, you shall. Shall speak. So faith is activated by the spoken word. The Bible says faith without result or without works is dead. We don't dispute, we don't argue that you have faith. But if you tell me that you have faith, you don't have proofs. It's a sign that your faith is dead. So faith produces result. Faith provokes the supernatural. Faith is the key to the world of possibilities. And whenever you engage in this realm, things, they just work smoothly. Faith, it is the key that can open any door. Any door. When Jesus healed this woman who was sick for 12 years, the Bible says she spoke to herself, if only I can touch the hem of his garment and I'll be made whole. She began first confessing, she began to act on the faith. And the Bible says, after she did that, she did not sit on one place. She stood up. She went and persisted in touching the hem of his garment. And the Bible says, at that moment, the same time when she touched him. Now you must understand that there was a lot of people touching him, but Jesus could not feel anything. So it's not your touch that causes Jesus to move, but it is the touch of faith. Then this woman touched Jesus, and the Bible says he had to stand and ask the question, who has touched me? This is my prayer for you tonight, that you shall touch him and he will stand still and ask, who touched me?
Amen.
And the Bible says when she touched him, the Bible says she was very afraid, because according to the law, a woman who was oozing blood, she was not allowed to mix with people who are normal. But the Bible says the moment she touched him, the Bible says blood ceased. Not only that, the Bible says when Jesus turned around, in fact, scripture says that power and virtue finished. Power and virtue finished. So the whole power that was invested in Jesus, and Jesus was going to another crusade. So the whole power that he fasted for 40 nights and 40 days, it was invested over one woman because of her faith. That's the reason we can come here. All of us, we are here. But let me tell you, the whole anointing can be invested on one person. And the Bible says when she touched him, the Bible says she was afraid. And Jesus turned around. And the Bible says when he looked at her, I love what he said. He said, your faith. Your what? Is it my faith that causes you to receive a miracle? No. It's not my faith. Jesus said, whenever you saw Jesus doing a miracle, he could tell people, your faith has made you well. The centurion man, Jesus said, I have never seen a man with such kind of a faith. Jesus said, your faith has healed you, which means the woman from home, she was already healed. By own faith, your faith. So whenever you must receive a miracle, your faith must be involved. This is not magic. That's the reason every time you see me when I'm praying for those that are sick, I can, with my grace of healing, I can decide to pray for the person and the person can be healed. But it becomes very hard if the person is completely without faith. And you see a person is just sitting looking at you. Are you going to be healed? And the person will be like, oh no, you know what, I've been sick. That's not the question. Are you going to be healed? You must answer yes. This man was by the pool. Jesus asked the question, what do you want me to do for you? And the man began to complain. I've been here for so many years. The question was, what do you want Jesus to do for you? And you are bringing your problems. What do you want Jesus to do for you? I'm asking you again. What do you want Jesus to do for you? There are some people here, they'll be complaining, yet Jesus is ready to solve their issues. They're complaining. No, you know, my dirts, I'm having dirts. No, you know, my husband wants to kick me out. You know, I don't have a child. You know, look at my hair is like, no, it doesn't matter. The question is, what do you want him to do for you? Just go direct to the point. Jesus, I've been here for so many years. I want to walk. Jesus, Jesus, I've been poor for so many years, I want to be rich. Jesus, I've been here for so many years, things are not working out for me, I want you to change my life. God wants you to go direct to the point. Don't begin to tell me that, you know, Jesus, that's a problem. You see, I would call a person, I say, can I prophesy to you? What do you want me to prophesy? And the woman will be like, anything. That's not the question. What do you want me to prophesy? You must speak. Okay, I want you to prophesy in this area. I want you to prophesy in this area. Be specific even in your faith. If your faith has stagnated for you to have a house, grow in that area. Listening. Say, I'm listening. Touch your ear. Say, you my ear. I command you. Open. In Jesus' name. So, you want a miracle, isn't it? Hey, do you want a miracle? Do you want healing? Do you want deliverance?
Yes.
You want your husband to come back?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
You want him to come back? Huh?
Yes.
Uh-huh. This is what I'm telling you now. If you want your husband to come back, he will not come back without your faith. Even the Bible says it is impossible to please God.
Amen.
Without faith, your husband is going for another one. Faith must be involved. Praise God. Number two. Number two. Confession. 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 The book of Job, the Bible says, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. You shall decree a thing and it shall be established. You, not me. You, not me. That's the reason you see me when I stand here, I tell you, speak whatever. And some people, they are waiting for me to lead them in prayer. You are joking, my brother. You are joking. You will leave here where the place is charged up with the anointing. You will leave empty. Because the Bible says, you shall decree, you, not me. It's a personal obligation. I cannot breathe on your behalf. I can't. So when it comes to declaration, confession, whenever you hear a prophet say, now, declare it. Oh my God. It is now your time now to release yourself in the spirit. God, I need this. I declare I am a successful man. I am healed. I am delivered. My husband is coming back. That's what God wants. He wants you to do it. It's not the time for you to begin now to look at your neighbor, to look at your pastor, whether he's not praying. It does not matter whether your pastor is not praying. He has told you, declare it. Amen. Lift your hands, declare for two seconds. No. That's not declaration. Declaration is not prayer. It's not speaking in tongues. That's wrong. Let me show you. Wait. Declaration is not speaking in tongues. Speaking in tongues is activating your spirit. Declaration is the ability to speak or to put a stamp on that which you want God to do for you in a twinkling of an eye. For example, I want change. I want change in my life. So I don't need to speak in tongues again. Now here I'm declaring it with my language. Lord, I need a house. I decree and declare in the name of Jesus. I stand on your word. I declare it is established. I am a success in the name of Jesus. I am blessed in the name of Jesus. My coming in is blessed and my going out is blessed. I declare I am wiser. That's declaration. No, shrika. No, there are different kinds of declaration. But the declaration of your needs is you to reach a level where you must pour them out. I declare in tongues. I can declare in tongues. And declare what I'm interpreting. But for you, you must tell him with your mouth. With your mouth. Lord, I declare this month, I receive my car. I receive my house. In the name of Jesus, this sickness, it will not kill me. I decree and declare, I am the healed of the Lord. That is a declaration. And let me tell you, most people who play with declaration, they end up becoming casualties. The power of my ministry is to declare. That's the reason you will see me. I'll be on the stage there. I'll declare for 1 hour. I'm declaring. I declare this. I declare that. I declare this. I declare that. I declare. And you know, some people, as I'll be declaring, that's when now they go on WhatsApp. You don't know. Let me show you. Do you know the power declaration? Whenever a prophet is saying, I declare. It's like God is a judge in heaven. He has a stamp. There is a difference between you speaking and declaring. Whenever you declare, God has a stamp. I declare money. God puts a stamp. Have it now. In Jesus' name. The moment you say in Jesus' name, God says, oh, let it be so. That's a power of declaration. Confession. Any person that enters the church without speaking anything, that person is nothing. If you enter church without opening up your mouth in declaration, my sister, it's better you never came to church. It's better. Confession. Whenever the prophet says, now time to declare, oh my God, you hold your stomach. There are different dimensions of declaration. If you feel like the Holy Spirit is leading you to speak it out, you want to speak out your needs, speak them out. If you feel like you are lacking words, enter in tongues. Confession. Number three. Are you ready? Huh? I'm teaching you how to receive. Because we have got a few minutes to be here. We have got 45 minutes to be here. What's the time? Yeah. By 8, we'll be done. By 8, we'll be done. And we'll go home. Hallelujah. Confession. Number three. Are you ready? Your offering. Your offering. No matter how much powerful the sermon is, if people are not givers, the blessing will bypass them. Let me tell you. You don't receive the blessing. I want to give you this. You don't receive the blessing. You don't receive the blessing after preaching or after teaching. You receive the blessing while the teaching is going on. Then what is the time to sow? During the time of teaching. Because the land, the ground is fertile. Even if you can come with your seed in my office, it can never be compared when I'm on my altar. It can't. Your time to sow your seed, your word, your car, your house, it is right here. When the word is coming forth, it comes with a lot of ingredients. And whenever you hear a prophet speak something that concerns you, don't just sit with your 10 rand in your pocket. Remove it. You think 10 rand can make you to be a millionaire? You know, some people, they're so stingy. They will
proceed with the 10 rand, they'll put it in their socks. And the word has been released that you shall be a millionaire. And they are sitting on the 10 rand. They say, I rebuke, I rebuke, I rebuke. That's the reason you end up becoming, a lot of people, they become poor during time for the service. Why? A word has been released for them, but they don't want to sow in it. That's the reason most of you, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. God is not after your money. God wants you to connect to him because he's a source of money. I told you last time. I said, God does not eat your money. It is us. I am a bank. Me here. I'm a bank of God. He has done a deposit of revelation. And I give to you. You have received it? Have you received the money? Huh? Have you received the money? Do back. Now, bring back. Hey, now you must do now a deposit back, because this bank, if you don't do a deposit, it will remain empty. What I mean is that if you don't connect yourself to the one who gives you every day, no matter how much you sit under him, you still become like Elisha with a bald head. Elisha was a prophet anointed by God. He died with leprosy. There was no people to sow in the anointing. That's the reason. Let me tell you, I don't love people that come in my office empty-handed. Not that I love money. But scripture can never be broken. Whether I'm a prophet, I will die, the word of God will remain. Someone will come, hey, Papa, you know my husband wants to kick me out of my house. I just say, I'm looking at you also. I say, hey. Yes, Papa. And you are on top of it, you are crying. He wants to kick me. You see, now he's working with another lady. I say, oh. If you are a wise woman, whenever you have an issue that takes away your faith, you don't come with words to a prophet. You come with a seed. You come with a seed, heavy seed, not this chicken seed or change seed. You take a seed, you come to a prophet and say, my prophet, I have never provoked you. Today I want to see your God. Do you think we need your money? If we needed your money, we wouldn't have been ministering to you every day. And you wouldn't have been coming to us, asking for prayer, financial prayer. If you are having money, why coming to me that I need my debts to be canceled? You are a millionaire. Between you and me, who is a millionaire? No, let's. Who is a millionaire? Eh? At the end of it, you will need my prayer to cancel your debts. Huh? They're about to fire you. What opens up the heart of a prophet is not your voice, it's not your face. No matter how much you can dress very nice, it does not move me. Whether you can sing, it does not move me. What moves me is your seed. I want to tell you this. If there is 17 sinners in the church who are givers, God will decide to kill the whole church who are holy and leave 17. I repeat again. If there are 17 sinners who are givers. God will decide to kill the whole church who are holy, because they are a wastage in the kingdom. Poverty in this kingdom is not permitted. It's not just about you being born again and you can't contribute anything. Even God says, why did I create this person? Do you know why God, let me show you something. Do you know why sinners make a lot of money? They are givers. Givers. Arabs, Muslims, they are givers. They don't know. They pray, Allah, Allah, wakuba, Allah, wakuba, Allah, 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 wakuba, Allah, 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 wakuba. With Allah wakuba, on top of it, they are driving Rolls Royce. Yeah! Yaris. We know God. And the God that they worship is a dead God. He's a dead God. He can't even heal anything. Yet they prosper. Do you know why they prosper? They are givers. In church, don't just be on the side of receiving. No! One of my secrets of my life is whenever I see a man who carries grace, what I do, I sow in their lives. I sow in their lives. My seed in their lives might not speak for me right there. But in the day of trouble, I understand. If you are not a spiritual man, your brother is healed. Or you are not receiving you. Yo, I say your brother is healed. Take a seat, go and sow. You want me to pray for you again? Take a seat and sow. It's done. Power. It's done. Just like that. You receive a prophecy, you sit down. The prophecy will stay for the rest of your life. The prophecy said that you get married next year. It's now 4 years. You are becoming a mama. With a prophetic word on your head. Me, I've seen people with prophecy like this dying. Dying! My son, yesterday, he was, somebody hit him, and he called me. Something jumped out. You know, there are sons who are given to you as a seed, as a blessing. I told him, I said, the day you will die, I'm not your father. The day you will die, I'm not your father. I've ever eaten your seed. So let your seed provoke my spirit. There is a prayer that is called the hatometer prayer. Not thermometer, hatometer. It comes from the deep of the heart. But your seed. Ministering and they were also connecting. What is ministering? They were also connecting. Receive your car, I connect. Receive your house, I connect. Receive your baby, I connect. Receive your debt cancellation, I connect. Just like that. This is how we receive things of God. Anyone who comes with money in the church and goes with money, that man is a stingy man. Because in the things of God, whenever the word is coming, you just can't remain with money. Why? Okay. Why money? I will show you. Why money? Because David said, I cannot give God what does not value him. whenever he wants to prophesy to you, there is a plate somewhere. There is a plate. And that plate, he will even tell you that before I prophesy to you, I need a white chicken, black chicken, a white goat. Huh? A white what? A white goat. And any witch doctor who tells you that he wants a chicken, he's angry, he wants to eat it with his family. I don't need a chicken. For where? And I need a chicken. Me? The way, look. Where? Where do I need a goat? For where? There about where? Hallelujah. Imagine you bring a goat, you like, Papa. Where? Look at my suit face. Where? Doctor, they give gods is because it is at the level of a witch doctor to receive a god. Not for me. To receive a chicken, for where? I've got a lot of chickens in my fridge. They are waiting for me to eat them. Your seed. Is not for your hand. Seed belongs in the ground. Anyone who remains with the seed in the pocket, that man will remain the same for the rest of his life. The seed, it is for sowing in the ground. And whenever you sow it in the ground, you must have a prophetic mind to water it via declaration, via your faith. It's not just about sowing. As you are sowing, let your faith be involved. And as your faith is involved, continue confessing. Lord, I saw in the life of this man of God. You said in your word, I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. I capture and I claim the anointing that protects this man. I've never been involved in a car accident. No day. If I ever, my wife, she can tell you, no day. If I ever stayed at home, he said, I'm sick. And they came with Panadol. Quinine, Droquin. No day where they took me at the hospital and said, no, now you must take porridge. All these men of God that are around me. Ha! Palusa Balia Duza. What about the seeds that I've been sowing? Even if when you want to kill me, you want to kill me. You are strong. You want to kill me. You must be strong. You must be a real man of God. Do you know how many seeds are behind me? That's the reason. Balaam could not curse Balak. In fact, he even began to confess, say, how can I curse that which the Lord has blessed? The man was a... He was a crazy sower. My daughters, let me tell you, no matter how you apply makeup, I'm your father. I will not lie to you. I have seen people that end up on makeup. They become like a graveyard. Like a dolly now, a dolly. 70-year-old dolly movie. The only work that is given is Brazilian hair at 70 years. I needed a miracle one day. I said, Lord, I want you to surprise me. Went out. One of my friends gave me $70,000. Cash. Give it to me. Because of sowing. This morning, I was asking God, God, I need finances. One of a certain man of God called me. He said, man of God, you know, I just want to bless you. Send me your account. He said, I'm doing a deposit of 70,000 rand. A life of sowing attracts sowers. The Lord spoke to me. I was telling him, I said, the Lord said, I must call the owner of the land. I heard it in the morning. The Lord said, call the owner of the land. Tell him that you will pay the land cash. And the Lord said, I will give you strategy on how to go about it. Even if when people they don't give, I will give you strategy. I will raise people in your midst. Those that don't look like they can sow, I will raise them up. And you are among them. If you don't receive it, it's your own fault.
Receive it.
The way you are receiving is like you are not ready for a miracle.
I receive it.
Rise up on your feet. If you did not sow the cloth that you are putting on your body, you would have come here naked. Even you had to sew on your body for you to be decorated. Even your car, you had to sew money for it to move. I had problems here in South Africa. I took a seed. I went to an anointed man of God. I laid on his feet. I said, I don't need many things. Just one word. Finish. Just tell me that I'm blessed. That's the only thing I need. And he said, you, for the rest of your life, no one will stand against you. That's the reason. Anyone who dares to stand against me, I'm like a canter. Because I understand how many seeds I've sown. A life of sowing provokes God. Lift up your hands. Say, Father, as I receive God's word, I decree and declare, bless me.
Bless me.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Lift up your hands and declare now.
Father, I declare, oh God, that you're going to bless me, oh God, that you're going to open our desires in the mighty name of Jesus. I believe, oh God, that I'm blessed. I believe my ears is open. I believe my heart is open. I declare my heart is open to receive that which you have for me in the mighty name of Jesus. I receive, oh God, all that, and I'm blessed of your word. Your words that you have released in my life, that I'm blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare that my doors are open. I declare that my heart will receive. I declare my heart is fertile. I declare I'm the blessed of the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. I will declare and declare, oh God, I am the leader, oh God. I declare, oh God, I will operate in speed.
Hallelujah.
I declare and declare that my all my
praise
doors
the Lord.
Are open. My financial doors are open.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the word that we received tonight.
Amen.
And oh Father, I pray that by the word of your servant, may many millionaires be made tonight for the sake of the kingdom of God.
I receive it.
The Bible says something that the word of God will never leave the mouth of God and come back to him the same way.
Amen.
I decree and declare in the name of Jesus.
I receive.
May your finances preach for you in the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive.
From tonight, people will never ask you who is your God.
I receive.
But they will know him by your finances in the name of Jesus.
I receive.
Now, what I want you to do, you see, the things of God are for two things. The whole of the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, it is for two things. You hear and you do. Tell your neighbor that the whole Bible.
The whole Bible.
Tell them. Say the whole Bible.
The whole Bible.
It is for two things.
It is for two things.
You hear.
You Pierre.
And you too.
Say,
my brother.
My sister.
If you are not careful enough,
tonight
I'm going to do the word of God.
And
if you don't do that word,
maybe tomorrow,
I will employ you.
Ask
them, what is it that you want tonight? Now say this, say, take your best seat. Talk to this person next to you. Say, take your best seat.
Take your best seat.
Because there is something that we are about to do in the realms of the Spirit.
Amen.
Tell them. Say, because there is something that we are about to do.
Because there is something we are about to do.
In the realms of the Spirit.
In the realms of the Spirit.
Do you have a seat with you?
Get a seat with you.
Glory to God.
Amen.
And right now, I don't want you to behave like a broke person. I want you to behave like a millionaire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you smile like what? Like a millionaire. There is a way millionaires praise and walk.
Amen.
I'm telling you the truth. I was saying to somebody that imagine I'm standing to a person who's asking 20 million or 20 rands from God or 20,000 from God. Then I said to this person, there are moments where you can become a solution to that person.
Amen.
Because you know who your God is.
Amen.
That means you can say, brother, I'm not praying for 20,000, I'm praying for 20 million. Tonight, I just want to become the answer to you.
Amen.
I don't know if you are getting what I'm talking about tonight.
Amen.
Now, what I want you to do, you see, the kind of a seed that you give will determine the fruits that are going to come to you.
Amen.
There was a time I was preaching, I said to somebody, you cannot plant bananas and expect oranges. It is not going to happen. Glory to God.
Amen.
You received a word, and as I was sitting there, the Lord began to show me that in these last days that we are in, there's what we call a transition in the realms of the Spirit. That means the kingdoms and the wealth of this world is being transferred from the unbelievers into the kingdom of God. Glory to God.
Amen.
Now, as you are coming, there is one thing that I want you to do tonight. Be fed up of the situation that you are at this present moment. Don't be too much conditioned to the level where you are. If you've been given 20 million to the house of God, say, Father, enough is enough. Tonight, may I move from 20,000 or 20 million into a higher dimension in the realms of the Spirit. Now, let me do something before we give offerings or before we give this seed. If you're saying, man of God, I've never saw what is a million rand with my eyes. If you are here, lift up your hand and let me see. If you say, I've never seen a million rand with my eyes, lift your hand. Let me show you the principles of the kingdom of God. Right now, as an apostle of God, I cancel that and I introduce you to the millions. Now, can I show you something? If you are saying, men of God, I have never seen a million rent with my eyes, lift your hand and let me see. You see, you missed. You missed. Because when I canceled it, I introduced you to the millions. But you are still acting like somebody who has never seen it in the realms of the Spirit. Take your best seat. Take your best. Are you sure that which you have is the best? Ask the person, are you sure? That is standing next to you. Say, are you sure? Lift it up. Lift it up. Hallelujah. And tonight, don't be ashamed. You know, the anointing that your father carries, I normally say that it's a bulldozing anointing. It can pull you from where you are into a higher dimension. Hallelujah. Lift the seat up. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight.
Let the angels of God. The angels of God.
Talk on my behalf.
Talk on my behalf.
By tomorrow. Let them mention my name.
Let them measure my name.
before influential people.
Before influential people.
Say, dear Father.
Dear Father.
I have a bank account.
I have a bank account
that I want you to fill with millions.
That I want you to fill with millions.
For the sake.